here, and this is the turboprop here for applying air for the aircrafts, moving air for the aircrafts. So the business general aviation, the catalyst engine I mentioned is powering these kind of small airliners, and also the marine and industrial, we call it M&I engine. To repeat, we are working on M&I engines here.
This logo, especially for you, because I see it in Turkish.
Which one?
Yes, it's this logo. This logo.
The logo.
GE. Yeah.
Logo.
Logo.
Yeah. Yes. This belongs to you because I see it in the buildings. It's the same.
Oh yeah.
Is the same?
Same. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Same. All the same.
Yeah. I thought this is big shops or something.
Yes. Yes.
You're
coming here. You saw this logo.
Everywhere I see this logo, like this one. Yes. This.
Yeah, it's, I mean, GE is a extremely big company that more than 350,000 employees working all around. And GE Aviation is a part of it. There are like 27 sub-companies, I believe, on the GE. One of the biggest is GE Aviation. There are the GE Healthcare, GE Power. We have also procured Alstom. That Alstom is pretty close here. The home appliance, lots of GE air brands. So GE Aviation is one of the biggest of those producing the engines. So these are the derivatives. So 8330, that's two ISO big airliners. 747, that is intercontinental flying aircrafts, powered by CF680C2, and E1 is its growth version. E1 is mainly derived the MS-100, and 6000 is from C2, and these are the megawatt levels, 100, 110, and 6000 is 40 to 55 megawatts. And so this is the C5, it's McDouglas, I believe, powered by TF-39 or CF6-6. We have this -6.
Just where?
Yeah.
What's the meaning of the CF6, this number is 21? What's it mean to? From where you get this, the numbers? What's it mean, this number?
Oh, these numbers?
Yes.
These numbers are,
as you said, now E1 is 100 megawatt.
No, these are not.